So we are a solar park company. Actually, there was one of the agenda in the discussion that someone should speak about what is an upcoming utility projects in the state and what's happening about it and how are we getting geared up for that. So here the discussion is all about, you know, throughout the day we have been listening about EPCs, the energy traders, the consumers and everything. Now behind this, there is something called as infrastructure that needs to be, catered to. For larger solar parks, typically government provides that infrastructure. If the solar parks are of 50 megawatt onwards, it's government. But where do people go for the solar parks which are of 2 to 20 megawatt capacity or 2 to 50 megawatt capacity? In most of the tenders that we see currently in the country is like all these small scale solar parks, EPCs are being told that you fetch your own land, you fetch your own permission, you fetch your own connectivity and just bid. So ultimately no assistance being provided by the government, but at the same time there is a pressure on them to bid at the same parity of pricing which they have done in Badla or Rewas and those things of the world. Now it becomes absolutely very difficult for EPCs whether to focus on their core business or go ahead with finding out the connectivities, getting land, getting the permissions, ROWs, transmission lines and whatnot. So that's where our company comes in. So as I said in the start, what is your core business? You focus on it. It's E, P, and C, okay? Getting land, getting permissions, going to the babus, all this is not your core business, okay? And that is our core business. We do that. Because we provide solar parks where we create simple plug and play infrastructure. When we say a simple plug and play infrastructure, you come to our park, you decide that there is a 2 megawatt customer, a 5 megawatt customer or whoever, okay? You have all of these things ready with us. Its infrastructure is ready, your land is ready, your connectivity is ready, your transmission line is ready, ROWs are in place, evacuation capacity is in place. So ultimately the lead time that you can give to your customer is the lead time how much you take it to install your panels. Because for us, we have kept that ready. And in our solar park, we have different capacities for different EPCs. So not every EPC, it's no more a big boys club. The idea is to make sure that the smaller EPCs can also offer ground mounted solutions to their customer from 2 to 20 megawatt, 2 to 30 megawatt, and then come to us to say that, okay, our customer is only 5 megawatt customer, but they want a ground mounted, and where do we go? So ultimately, we will give that solution. And what we do in our park, we house such EPCs of different variations and different requirements and make a consortium of them to manage that particular solar park. So effectively, either we do the O&M or we ask the biggest EPC who has consumed the biggest share of that park to continue to do with the O&M. So we are quite flexible on that front. And therefore, when we say that solar park is no more only to be dependent on governments or on the bigger players, we have identified such opportunities across the state, whether if you take the recent tender of Genco, MSEDCL, everyone is just going away from all those basic responsibilities of giving you a ready infrastructure. And that's what we are thinking, that we should be in a position to fill that gap. So you as a EPCs, as a manufacturers of various things, if at all you come across such customers where they want a housing facility, we are there and we will give you the plug and play environment that we promise. So currently we have our sites in Nagpur, Yavatmal, Wardha, so and many more in, you know, effectively we also go to Chhattisgarh. So we are trying to increase our footprint into the different states as well.